Hello, we will study about the epithelial tissue. The epithelial tissue is lining the surface of the body or the lumen of an organ. All the epithelium has basically two components, cells and basement membrane. Cells are of different types based on the function and the location of the cell or the role of the epithelium that it is dealing with. Basement membrane is an amorphous layer on which the epithelium is resting. The peculiarities of all the epithelium is that they are avascular in nature. That means there is no blood vessel running into the epithelium. Then how does this epithelial cells get their nourishment? It is simply through diffusion through the basement membrane to the deepest layer of the cell. If it is a multi-layered epithelium, this diffusion continues to the most superficial layer of the epithelium. So all the epithelium are devoid of blood vessels. There may be nerves running between the epithelial cells. Epithelium is basically classified into simple epithelium, has only one single layer of cells. Stratified epithelium means they are multi-layered. When you take this simple epithelium, these are simple squamous, simple cuboidal, simple columnar, again subdivided into brush border and striated border. And pseudostratified. So these are the types of simple epithelium. We will see this simple epithelium one by one. The standard staining of the histology slides is H and E. H stands for hematoxylin, which is blue in color, that stains the acidic part of the cell, and eosin is pink in color, that stains relatively the less acidic part of the cell, that means the cell membrane and the cytoplasm. Many small cell organelles are also stained with this hematoxylin or eosin based on their acidic nature. Whenever you draw an epithelium, start with the basement membrane. Here, I am drawing the simple squamous. Squamous means they are tile-like, they are scale-like. They are flat cells. When we take a section of the epithelium through its thickness, we can see that the cells has an elevated part and a thin part, and it has a spherical nucleus placed in the thickest part of the cell. So here is the cell, that is a nucleus, and there is basement membrane. Example of simple squamous epithelium is endothelium. Endothelium is the lining epithelium of blood vessels, alveoli of lung. All these are the examples of simple squamous epithelium. Simple cuboidal, the basement membrane, the cells are cubical, so it has same height, same width and same thickness. The nucleus is large, prominent, and it is placed at the center of the cell. Here is nucleus, epithelial cell, basement membrane. Example of location of simple cuboidal epithelium is thyroid follicle, ducts of exocrine glands. The moderately active thyroid is said to be the typical example of simple cuboidal epithelium. The simple columnar epithelium. As the name says, the cells are columnar in its appearance. That means these are tall cells. The surface of all the epithelium is relatively flat, or a smooth round surface, To correctly draw a simple columnar epithelium, keep this tip in mind. If you consider the breadth of a cell, at least this cell should be 3 times the height. This is 1, 2 and 3 times the height of the breadth. If you are drawing like this, this is almost 2 times the height of the cell. We call this as the log columnar cell. What if it is too high? 1, 2, 3, 4 and more. If it is too high, we call it as tall columnar cell, which is not typical columnar cell. Peculiarity of the nucleus is it has an oval nucleus and the nucleus is placed towards the base of the cell or close to the basement membrane. Keep this in mind. The nucleus is placed in the lower one third of the columnar cell. If you think like that, you won't make a mistake. So that is a typical columnar epithelium. This is the epithelial cell. That's the nucleus and basement membrane. That's a plain columnar epithelium. I told there are few modifications of the columnar epithelium named brush border and striated border. This brush border and striated border are two surface modifications of the epithelium. Here is the difference of the brush border and striated border. I am drawing two columnar cells to show you the difference. In the first one, the brush border, these are surface hair-like projections named as cilia. So these are not actual surface projections. These are something else which protrude out, which protrude towards the surface. These are cilia and they are motile. And this kind of columnar epithelium is seen where it need to move the content of the lumen. For example, in the fallopian tube, it is lined by brush border columnar epithelium. And how does it differ from that of the striated border? These are fine microvilli projecting on the surface. The main purpose of this microvilli projecting onto the surface is to increase the surface area, and this kind of columnar cell is seen where there need more absorption, like in the small intestine or in the gallbladder. If I modify this into brush border and striated border, this appears like this, brush border, and striated border appears more regular. And it appears like a border when you look it through the microscope. So here is the brush border. This is the striated border. The next is pseudo stratified. This name is a little bit tricky. Pseudo stratified. It looks like a stratified epithelium, but it is pseudo. It is a false stratified. It gives a false impression that it is a stratified epithelium. The reason is, this is actually one single layer of cell. That's a basement membrane. And the difference is that actually this is a modified variety of columnar epithelium. And you can see that there are cells which are of varying height, and the thickness of the cell is different in its different parts. There are tall cells, medium cells, short cells, tall cells, medium cells, tall cell, small, tall, medium. There is no specific arrangement pattern, but the cells are like this. It appears to be of different height, so that the breadth of the cell in different parts is different. And the nucleus is oval nucleus. I told this is a modified variety of columnar epithelium. And the nucleus are placed in different levels. So while looking through the microscope, we actually won't see the cell boundaries. Instead, we identify the cell or epithelium by looking at the presence of nucleus and the stain of the overall cell. So this kind of epithelium is that When you look through the microscope, we get a false impression that this is a multi-layered epithelium. So actually, this is one single layer of epithelium. Mostly the pseudostratified epithelium will be with surface modification of cilia. And the typical example of this is trachea. This is all about this simple epithelium.